final race of the season. Good performance in. I think we'll be able to do more upgrades just by upgrading the parts thing to level 3. It's just. This is stripped too far. Okay. Okay, where are we? What are we at? 98%. Actually, we want more understeer. Can't think of a good way to promote that. Yeah, this is just bleh. Do we just put it down and hope that somewhere we kind of edge it in? Alright, let's try it. So that. And we might perfect the balance too. Maybe. We'll see. I have Aparicio to Leroy. It does frustrate me when the setups are so finicky and getting that like final percentage point. But in practice, like 98 will race fine. We'll be losing a huge amount of time. But it's just the inefficiency bothers me. But if they shorten practice sessions, we'd be struggling to. We'd be struggling to hit 98% probably. Because you just have less time to tune it. It'd be much harder to hit 99. It's mostly just down to the way it works. Bong. Let me just hit the pause button and check this quick. Yeah. Just some instant messaging with my sister and she just sent me a thumbs up, which. Okay. Nice. Looks like we can give oversteer. So we'll run this to about 215 and do exactly that. And then Leroy goes out behind him. That's the design I want. I think we're in a similar boat in the downforce where we could strip a little down to get. Sometimes the extra percentage is hiding in the downforce. This is really hard to tell. Yeah, good warm up. We need a couple more attempts to catch those, Windsor / Williams cars. We're in green, and we're also in green there. Not what I was looking for, but we do at least have one car ahead of the Windsors, which is completely okay. Yeah, we're just like coming about 1 to 2 seconds behind pace. With where we're at now, it just takes a lot to bring that in. Forecasting center. Be a nice thing to upgrade when we have more money. For right now, though. Why don't I just take like 2 laps of fuel out? Annoying. Run the car lighter, maybe we'll get a little something something. It's a race that's tough on the engines, so it seems like a good idea to just run them lighter on fuel. It looks like Leroy realized pretty quickly that she's gonna have to take care of the engine. Vanclusian's being kind of annoying, but he's not going to be in the way too much longer either. Thank you. Interesting. So we can't team order by Leroy. Zaporizhia will just have to overtake her, legitimate, if he's actually quicker. Aparicio's got the speed. Unless we get enough money, we can probably build up tire heating and tire wear. I usually trend towards tire wear because I like having better tire wear than everyone else. It's just my thing. Looks like the tire wear is going to even out. Oh, the Aparicio is going to need to save, and that's going to uneven a little bit. Yeah, the speed dynamic I think might shift when the rain stops. It might not either. There's a lot about this I don't really know. Yeah, we're just watching the laps tick down and just hoping things will kind of work out for us. Once the rain actually does stop, it's gonna dry quick. And Naito gets by. Kind of dropped off. Your projections are positive. Yeah, once the rain lets go, we are going to dive into the pits. Because it's gonna... The water level is gonna drop like a rock. Oh wow, they're going off of projections. I must have forgot to switch over the pit crew. Pitting based on what they project the track to look like, which is really, really silly. So before the rain stops. The entire team. Just hurts the whole team. I guess we're gonna find out how quick these tires are too. I suspect there's some speed on them. And I think we just run them to range, and that should cover us. It's gonna be hard for the AI to push on these. Looks like a lot of the soft runners are gonna try, but it looks like stopping for these tires may end up being a mistake. We'll see though. If I can get some running time on them, I think I can probably create a gap. Peach is pushing, which they're running cycles where I think they can have decent push windows. Alright, let's see what happens. Thank you. Naito. I feel like they might struggle a little bit. Yeah, Leroy's struggle is going to be maintaining her pace. So 25% is where we're going to pit these guys. Over full race distance, these are the tires. But I think. Yeah, they might have a tough time finishing. And any AI struggles are going to benefit us. Yeah, I can't use Team Orbs right now for the obviously faster Aparicio. I can pit Leroy, but we don't want to, like, blow that option too early either. She is probably hurting our path forward now, actually. Without pushing myself, I don't think there's any way we can, make the move work. Try for a burst. And it's not gonna work because she just. She's actually just recovered some speed. This is hurting our race. No doubt. I'm actually just waiting her out. Naito is out. That works out for us. Alright. Turn it back up. She has to slow down. That was my basic idea, is just to wait her out and then just, you know, try here. Yeesh. Yeah, there's gonna be a struggle. Even on on the hardest tire. Now she's just gonna destroy the tire. I probably have to bring her in now, actually. Yeah, we'll save stop. And then we'll try to bring Aparicio in, and we'll just try to another pit mistake. That should do it. We need to push hard to kind of make sure. No, we're pitting, so it doesn't matter. Right in between, and actually will work out for Leroy. It'll work out for Aparicio as well. He's on the right side of this. Let her by if you want to finish ahead of her. Yeah, not having control of her race is gonna hurt us now. Yeah, on my own style, I don't like pushing. I really, really dislike it. But the only thing I can do now is just kind of slop behind and hope we work our way forward. Grace Beach that we want to She's just gonna try to yeah. No, I see what she's going to try to do, and I don't like it. Because we're 14 seconds behind, and we're not really catching her that fast. Man, we're gonna get lapped at this rate. Team 22, and Leo is just way faster at the moment. And this is going to completely undermine our approach, too. I have a tactic, but it sits on us having to do all three laps, which means overtaking Leroy. Yeah, sorry, I can't team order you by. You're gonna have to overtake her. It looks like she's gonna make it, which sucks. I don't think we're even getting by Leroy. Okay, we're getting by Leroy. Too late to help, though. Oh, maybe. Liao finishes. I think we're too far behind. Think we're probably too far behind. We're definitely a fifth place team though. We'll see how the off season plays out. Menendez demoted, but not enough to help us. And a solid fifth place. Down to 19. Wow, we finished with a 19 million surplus. That's pretty dang good. Steinman wraps up everything. Just that team is right now. That team is just really, really, really good. Huh. I have an opportunity to bring in some better, a little bit better pit crew. I should probably seize it. Upgrade probably works. So, yeah, let's start sticking some of these 19s in there. Starts looking good. Rejecto. Car repair finished. Yeah, and all I can do is put as much work into that as possible, though. prize money. It's a lot. ZRT's chairman is going to retire at 72. Okay. Let's keep rolling the timer. Velen Racing decided not to take my offer to join WMC. McNeil Racing will stay. Vexla's promoted. Dragon Race, Team Race China goes down. And our upgrades. Jeez. Okay. Let's see what we have tucked away for money. Cracking on the new chassis, which we only get another 15 million for? Okay. Fuel supplier varies. $55 we'll be left with. Least amount we need to complete the star. And then we just max improvability as well. Go to 27 mil HQ. I can't swing it. At least not based on any of that. Shoot. I left a little bit of put quite enough tire wear in. Nippon. Oh, we should actually have new drivers to scout, and I should get to scouting them. Basically looking for someone of Leroy's potential and sponsorship value. But we're probably not going to just find that. Very hard to find and replace that. If we see someone, we need to like watch them, basically. Got another. Tick off the time. T- Tire simulators. That fills us. I should set up to 4 because I usually do get that. A unique opportunity to sabotage Rossini, which not gonna do it. Livery for 2028. Trying to decide. Livery pack. Thinking maybe that painty one. Doesn't really look like much at a distance. Nothing drastically altering or anything like that, just something a little different. Yeah, what I should do is aim for 4-star, and then I get a little bit more tire heating, and I can just do that tire simulation thing. Preseason testing coming up. And now we're gonna see where we. Oh, that's nice. So we're 6th and 11th. 6 is actually very, very encouraging. Where are we? We're 6th best. All right, the single most important thing that would sink us. Yeah, we need this. It's just gonna give us so much more room to upgrade. This level of sponsorship money I like. And the race lineup is gonna be the same. Alright. I think our tactics are gonna be a little bit more focused this season. So we're going to we want to set all this up. Who starts with the best car? Is it Leroy? Okay. front wing. Gearbox and then engine, I think. But what we're gonna do is focus on these three specifically. At least to start. Bam, my primary thinking on it. 3, 4. Yeah, the front wing is gonna be like instantly trashed. Start here. Those are terrible to go through. Probably that one. When we pop through this level. Yeah, 80% as far as we're gonna take the initial parts of anything. And then the rest of this just will focus on bringing the wing up to par. Okay. I just need to remind myself at some point to split the playlist off at this point. And I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna get myself some more water. And we'll kick off season 13 after I'm back.